So this is no laughing matter. You say, why do you make a joke out of it? Because you're a serious audience tuned in here. You're trying to really be involved and trying to take action. You are the tip of the spear. How do we get this, though, as a Trojan horse to the liberals and to the young people that don't want to be serious? You do it like this.
Welcome to Lilypad Lane, and here's your host, Geronimo Frost.
Look at me again, Frost. I'm so cool, I'm silly. I'll never have children, and I'm sterilized. But the media says I'm totally cool. I'm a gay frog, I'm a gay fish. It's so good that I think my daddy atrazine.
Thanks to atrazine, there'll be no more frogs. But we're gay, so it's cool. Thanks, atrazine.
Atrazine is a human sterilization agent.
Before we go to our special guest, Atrazine, I wanted you to hear from one of our biggest supporters, David Hogg. He understands the bigoted, anti-Semitic, racist hatred of people like Alex Jones that have warned that frogs are becoming sterilized and gay from major scientific studies. Of course we are. It's so cool. Let's hear from David Hogg first. Oh, David.
I won't want to mention his name. When individuals say these things to us, I think it's important for their viewing audience to realize they're simply trying to make money off them. For example, one of the main people in this situation that I don't want to name the name of, but as you said, is from Infowars. He shouts a lot. I'll just give you that hint. He looks red. He's advertising many of these things, and the power lies in these advertisers to pull out of these fear-mongering, hate-loving people that just want to spread hate and division in America. For example, on Infowars, one of the main things that he spoke, one of his famous things is saying that, one of his most famous statements was saying that tap water is turning the frogs gay and will turn you gay too. First off, gay people are awesome. I don't think that's a problem at all. And secondly, if you notice at the end of that video, he advertises water filters. Interesting.
Thank you, David. Thank you. In fact, national media said that it was a covert death threat when Alex Jones' son went on and told David Hogg we should filter our water because of atrazine and other chemicals. That was a death threat. Being sterilized and dying is good. Trying to help people's bad. Rex Jones, bad. Alex Jones, bad. Gay frogs, good. Atrazine, good. I had trouble breathing, and they say I'm going to die soon, but it's okay. Atrazine, I love you. Let's talk to Atrazine now.
Look how popular
you are
now.
Hold on, Mr. Atrazine, I'm talking to you in a moment. I'm talking about my biggest fan, David Hogg.
Oh, yes, you've taken the bait.
Okay, we'll go to you now then. God, oh my God.
Go away.
You still are wonderful. Okay. Why are they lying about you and saying mean things about you and trying to keep you from the human children's water? After all, you give people such gifts. Why are they doing that, Mr. Atrazine?
Of course, my son. You're absolutely right. There's nothing wrong with atrazine and other carcinogens in the water to give you this gift that you now have. A gift that's so special. A gift that means the end of the frogs. Yes, you are a product of collateral damage in a larger program. And the fact that Stephen Colbert and my other agents have turned this into a joke is all the more delicious. As the human sperm counts drop, as fertility has ended, as diseases and cancers in children skyrocket, all of you bow to the mutagenic power of atrazine man. And you, my beautiful frog, are the last of your kind. You will be studied by future races that visit the planet as an extinct species, all bowing to me, atrazine.
Atrazine is what helps us become sterile and die. It's liberal, and don't be racist against atrazine. Ask any gay frog. It's good to never have any more frogs. It's good for our species to go away, or you're racist. I'm so cool now, Mr. Atrazine, that I'm sterile and dying early and have four eyes. But there's bigots out there who fight the transhumanist trans system, and they say that the mutations are bad and that we should worry about deadly chemicals or sterilization. Why do they do that? Why are they against the gift you've given us of atrazine?
Every human watching, not just frogs, not just other animal life, needs to know, never filter your water. Cook with bisphenol A. Radiation is good for you. The world government is good for you. Just submit.
This hour brought to you by Syngenta and atrazine and Roundup from my good friend over at Monsanto. Drink up. No more pain. You die. Thank you, gay frogs. Atrazine's good. There's not a chemical program to reduce fertility. Infowars is sorry. Please let us back on Twitter. Google, let us back on. We're sorry. Frogs are not gay. Atrazine is good. Infowars bad. Thank you, tech leader.
Living in Volcano may sound more dramatic than it really is. The real drama can be found here in Leilani Estates. But a lot of us on the Big Island rely on rainwater, and we need to be concerned about ash and acid rain.
Volcanic ash may contain heavy metal particles, and acid rain could lower the pH of the water to unhealthy levels. To find out, we employed a series of tests for heavy metals, alkalinity, and pH. What we learned was that there was, in fact, unhealthy levels of heavy metals and acidity in the rainwater. Next, we tested the water from our Alexa Pure gravity filter. And not only were the heavy metal levels within safe measure, but the pH was also restored to optimal levels. As it turns out, the filter on the Alexa Pure raises the pH of the water. So what we've learned is that volcanic ash and acid rain can contaminate a rainwater supply. But more importantly, a good water filtration system will purify it.
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance.